Students, welcome to science class. Today we learn about pressure from the chapter force and pressure, and we'll discuss the relation among pressure, force and area. Now children, when we walk on the muddy road, our feet sink. Why? Or when we sit on a sofa, the sofa sink. Then when we cut any fruit with the help of knife, it becomes easier. And why it is easy to prick a sharp nail in the wooden board or wall? That is for the pressure. The combined effect of force and pressure is expressed by the quantity pressure. The force acting on unit area is called pressure. So pressure is equal to force by area. So here the force will take the perpendicular force with the surface. The another norm of this perpendicular force is thrust. So force also, pressure also can be written as equals to thrust by area. Now there is an activity which help you to understand more about it, how pressure exert. Hold a sharp pencil between your two finger and start pressing it from both sides. Notice how will you feel on both fingers. Do you feel pain in any of your fingers? And notice the finger in which pencil leaves a deeper mark. It is very clear from this picture that if we consider the left hand finger, the tip of the pencil has sharp area. So the left finger will feel more pressure than on the right finger, because here the end of the pencil is blunt, that is large surface area. So the tip of the pencil with the small surface, that is pointed end of the pencil area, has more effect of force than the head of the pencil with large surface area. So the tip of the pencil which is sharp leaves a deeper mark and not the other blunt head. So that is the effect of force when contact area is small. That means more surface area exert less pressure on the finger, and less surface area exert more pressure on the finger. So here we, from this relation, it is very clear that the pressure is proportional to the force. That means more force we exert, pressure will be more, and pressure is inversely proportional to the area. That means more is the contact area, less is the force, and lesser is the contact area, more is the pressure. So to get a more pressure on an area, thus contact area should be less. For this, the iron nail, it is very easy to prick with the sharp or pointed end than that of the blunt end. Where blunt end, the force given on the blunt end. Next, so we got that pressure has magnitude only, it has no direction, so it is a scalar quantity. Instead it depends on force, but it is not a vector quantity, it has only magnitude. SI unit of pressure is Pascal, that is Newton per meter square, and CGS unit of pressure is dyne per centimeter square. Now pressure is directly proportional to the force and inversely proportional to area of contact. So directly proportional means when force increases, pressure increases, and inversely proportional means when area increases, pressure decreases. So pressure is proportional to the force applied and inversely proportional to the contact area. So here more is the area, less is the pressure, and less is the area, more is the pressure. Now some application of pressure in our daily life. Here are two pictures given, which is the effects of small surface area where more pressure exert. So first one, It becomes easier to cut things with the sharp knife than blunt one because the sharp knife has less contact area, so pressure exerted on an object becomes more. So the effect of force is more for that very sharp edge of the knife. And sharp end of the nail can be inserted on the wall or wooden board by hammering on its blunt side. This is also the advantage of sharp pointed end. You have seen, if I try to insert the nail with the blunt end towards the board or the wall, and if we try to hammer on the sharp end, then it will be difficult to insert this one inside the wooden board, and on the wall it is not possible. So sharp end of the nail can easily insert it because of the small contact area where effect of force or pressure is more. Next, skier use flat and long skis to slide on the snow. So here you can see the larger surface area of the skis help them to slide on the snow. So with the help of the flat skis, the pressure on the snow become less, so it doesn't sink into the snow. Next, the rear wheel of trucks are made broader, so that you can see the rear wheel, these are broader wheels which exert pressure less on the road, on the ground. And not only that, the broad wheels also helps to carry heavy loads on the truck. The broad feet of camel help them to walk on the sand. So you can see than that of the other animal like horse or donkey. Though the feet of the camel are like this and these are broad. So the broad feet help them to walk easily on the sand. For these broad feet, the camel's feet do not sink into the sand. Another example given, the broad straps of school bag help to reduce the pressure on the shoulder of the students. So not only students, the broad straps of the bag helps to reduce the pressure on the shoulders of all the persons. So these also example of broad or large area. So these are the application where large area reduce pressure, and the application that we learn here, the small surface area increase pressure, which is necessary. So according to the need, the surface area of the objects are made and sharp and blunt. So in this picture, the surface area should be more flat to reduce pressure on the ground. Here also, the broad feet of the camel reduce pressure on the sand, broad strap of the bags reduce pressure on the shoulders. Now there is an example. You can see here where we will see the same object having different surface area exert different pressure. So here in this picture you can see the weight of the object is 100 newton. So 100 newton is object is placed on a surface by lying on area 0.1 meter square, and then by keeping the object standing with the surface area 0.01 meter square. So when the object is placed on a surface having more surface area, that is 0.1 meter square, that time the pressure is 100 newton by 0.1, that is 1000 pascal. And when it is kept by keeping this one on area 0.01, the pressure become 10,000 pascal. So it is very clear from this pressure exerted by different area that when the object is kept on more surface area is exert less pressure, and when it is kept on 0.01 meter square, other surface area is less, then is exert more pressure. So for the second case, the pressure in the same way the first case we can find out. So 1000 newton, this is the force or weight of the object by surface area, that is 0.01, and we got 10,000 pascal. So students, in this way you are to find out pressure exerted by different objects having different surface area with the help of this formula, pressure equals to force by area. Okay, next day we will learn about pressure exerted by liquid and gas. Thank you for watching the video.